Hi everyone, this is Autopostrophe. And we're going to continue our game of Metal Gear Solid 5, The Phantom Pain. Hosted by your friend, Pear-Shaped Snake. The sneakiest agent in the world. Undetected by forces unseen. Nobody will even know I'm here. Except when I show up blatantly right in front of their face. That's the only time they'll spot me. All right. Oh, we don't have a waypoint. Oh no. Never mind. We do. Here we go. All right. Let's go sneak up on somebody. Some unsuspecting people. Alright, I'll just use my creep vision here.
Analysis complete.
Scope out my prey.
Analysis complete.
You're a C in fighting, that's not too bad, huh? So are you. Okay, that's right. The guys in front are not completely incompetent. Everybody else is, though. Let's see here. I think I have to go around the other way to see everybody else. Yeah, see, they have all the morons right in front, and there's the two smart guys at the outpost, and everybody else is just like a grunt. Doesn't know much more other than calling for help. Oh, come on. There we go. He's a little better. Nobody at the tower. Alright, so I probably want to capture the two guys in front. Since they have a skill set. But that'll be tough to do. Nobody up there either, huh? Ah, interesting. I already scoped some people out. So let's see how we want to approach this. I imagine that I want to take these two after I'm done with my mission objective. Since the whole place will be in chaos, I'm sure, while I leave. Hey. Ah, the two smart guys. Why did the smart guys always go away?
Analysis complete.
Well, you're not very smart. You're a little bit better. Okay, let's go from the other side, I think. Seems like a better option. Or I guess it doesn't matter, either way. Let's see, is this guy paying attention to me? No, he's facing the other way. That's good. Let's see, which way are you guys heading? Are you coming back? Oh, looks like you're cutting back this way. Okay, no problem. I will wait. I should be farther away from this. Where'd you go? Oh, they have matching shirts. How cute. Wonder if they're a couple. Are you guys just gonna stand around there or what? Yeah, see, this place doesn't. It doesn't seem as guarded over here. Whereas if I go up the canyon, it seems like there's more trouble. Okay, well. I don't know how good their vision is. It seems like they're all like 10-20 vision, you know? Or is it 30-20 vision? I don't remember. 30-20, I think, is more appropriate. Right, I'm just gonna act like a snake, crawl around the ground here. Whoop! Ah. Oh, maybe I should have different camo for this, huh? It doesn't matter. Guys, like, who is that humping the ground out there? Is that Bill? Oh, God. I always thought he was a weirdo. That's my problem with stealth games. It's just your mode of locomotion is always going to be the most painful, slowest method. So in reality, this mission is probably only, you know, 3 or 4 minutes long, but
a crack would make a good foothold.
Oh yeah.
Use crack climbing to make your way up.
Oh yeah, I love crack, I'm addicted. On people, yeah, on girls, not the actual drug. That's too much. It's too much of a bother. I can barely motivate myself to play this game.
Analysis complete.
Ooh, you're a dumbass. Yeah, congratulations. Ooh, well, you're a genius compared to your friend up there. I bet, like, he looks at your math test, and then he wonders why he fails. And you have to reveal to him that you only got a D.
You have arrived at your destination.
Oh yeah, you better believe. I am just gonna sneak past this entire brigade. They will have no idea what hit them. Well, I'll sneak past the first guy, and then I'll alarm everybody else, and then they'll all have to die. Just like the last mission. But thankfully, this game allows for that kind of flexibility. If I was playing Splinter Cell, you know, as soon as you touch somebody, die! God damn it, Fisher. I'm like, ugh. Why? You said leave no evidence. I was gonna kill everyone. And then burn the place down. There would have been no evidence. Alright, where are you going, buddy? Are you a moron or a genius? I'm gonna guess moron.
Analysis complete.
Oh, well, not complete moron, but certainly not gonna win any awards. It's okay, buddy. It's okay. We're gonna talk about the fantasy league. You know, the one that you want to start up. Yeah, soccer or whatever they call it around here. You guys like soccer, don't you? What do you mean football? No, you don't know what you're talking about. That's not what football is. It's not a cultural thing. What are you talking about? They don't tell you anything? You're right, I should let you go. There you go. Say hi to your parents. Oh, should I make it less obvious? Here, come on. Come on, we're gonna go bitty by right over here. This is where they expect you to be anyway. Loafing off. Ugh. I keep arriving at my destination. What the heck? Oh, damn it. Who knew that was there? Well, these guys probably did, but I'm not going to ask them. Oh, you're... Oh. It's okay. You're gonna be fine. I have no intention of hurting you.
Boss, you've entered a building.
Yeah?
Always keep an escape route in mind when you head indoors.
I will.
If you get surrounded, you'll have nowhere to run. Speak.
The map has been updated.
Where are your friends?
I've got nothing to say. Yeah. This could have ended differently, you know. I'm just kidding. Yeah. I would have killed you anyway. Oh, let's leave him up here, huh? Or, actually, can we throw him out the window? Let's do that instead. Oh, I can't. Damn it. Righto. All right. There we go. Put you behind the stairwell. There we go. Yeah. Good job, buddy. I bet you're going to turn and face me as soon as I walk over there, aren't you? What? Who saw me? Don't panic. Ah, it took a long time to open that door. Nah, I won't equip the chicken hat. I won't do that. Well, maybe. Maybe I should. Alright, where were we? Over there. Right. Okay, let me put my sneaking hat on. Alright, let me look for that girl's crack. Where is it? Yeah, it's always different on every person. Oh yeah, they can't see me. No way they could possibly see me like this, yeah. Okay, well, killing that first guy seemed, neutralizing that first operative seemed okay. Okay, well, I got here a little quicker than last time. Let's wait for our little friend. Oh man, you're one of those slow walkers. Gotta hate being behind you when I'm shopping.
I'm just going to take my time.
No, hurry up. I can feel myself getting closer to the retiring age. The longer it takes for you to get to the bananas. I need pickles too. Hurry your ass up. Ugh. I wouldn't eat those together, if you're wondering. Two separate items. Okay, good. You arrived at your place. Congratulations. Yeah. Yeah. Are you having a good day? Yeah? Thought about picking up any insurance? I know, all those guys that want to sell your insurance are just like, nothing will ever happen to me. I've been alive for XX years, yeah, I'll be fine.
Great. I've updated the info on your iDroid. Take a look. I hope he's all right.
The map has been updated.
Why don't they tell you anything? I'm very disappointed. Oh well. Alright, well, you stay right there. I'm gonna talk to one of your friends. Maybe they know something.
You have arrived at your destination.
Oh man, you know smoke is gonna kill you, right? You really shouldn't smoke. Or vape. It's so totally annoying. Look at that. I'm so noiseless. Oh. I guess we can talk right here. Make it quick, though. No, nobody's gonna help you. Nothing to say? Oh, okay. Talk to the knife. Alright. Well, this is going much better than before, huh? There we go. Yeah, good place for you. Whoop. You just lay right there.
You have arrived at your destination.
Okay, who else can we pick off here? I mean, infiltrate. All right, so we know there's guys on the other side. Oh, hold on a minute. Thank you.
Boss, you've entered a building. Always keep an escape route in mind when you head indoors. If you get surrounded, you'll have nowhere to run.
Come on up, come on up. Death is calling. It's like Final Destination, you can't escape. Final Destination 1, at least. I don't know about the other ones. Are you inside? Oh, well, I guess we're gonna pick off everybody else then. I hope you made your peace with all these guys. Paid up all your debts, whatever, you know. This guy's sleeping, man. Everybody else is working hard, and there's always one guy sleeping. You know what? It's because you guys are enablers, that's why. You let him get away with it. Nobody's gonna disturb his sleep.
That material. It could be just what we need to develop new weapons and equipment.
Alright, so somebody saw me, so they should be on their way in here. Right? That's what logic would dictate. Shh. Don't let them know I went out the window. Okay, you just keep sleeping. Oh, I didn't even take a look at you. Well, what do you look like?
Analysis complete.
Oh, he's not a winner either. Too bad for you. This is why you hire better agents.
Spit it out.
The map has been updated.
Where are your friends?
Nothing to say. Yeah, here we go. Someday I'm gonna run into somebody that actually says something. Or maybe he doesn't have any well, now I feel bad. Maybe he doesn't have any friends. He's just like, oh, no, these are really more like acquaintances. I don't really consider them friends. I never really thought about that. Well, I'm sorry, guy. Maybe you should open up more. Don't be such a loner. Oh, I took that tape. No more hollow notes for you, huh? You gotta listen to the Bee Gees. Let's see, these guys are always facing towards me, so let's walk around. Beasting. Shake it off, buddy. It's nothing. He just fell asleep, man. What's the big deal? Come on, guys. Where could I be? Oh, man. Thank you, Siri. Everything's fine. Don't panic. Don't panic. We're just gonna walk over here.
Updated.
Come on, I can't just leave you to die in a dirty place like this. I'll have you die in a dirty place like this instead. There you go. Ah, oh, cat's out of the bag. Hi. You guys should get right here and try to get me. Right here, right here. Oh, are you kidding me?
Boss, what happened? Boss!
Oh, nothing. Ah, maybe I should approach this differently. Oh, what do you think, huh? Man, they're all too close together. That's the problem. You can't see me. All right, I'm gonna grab that crack.
That crack would make a good foothold. You can use crack climbing to make your way up.
This mission might take me like longer than the whole game to play, to finish. I don't know how they got the angle on me, though. I mean, not as if their bullets can, like, curve around corners. Or maybe they can. I don't know. In the world of Metal Gear, you know, anything is possible. Okay, so let's try this again. I'll make sure to steal that stuff next time. Oh, where's that guy? Oh, he's late. Man. Well, I wouldn't want him to miss this for the world. He is going to be really happy he woke up today. He was like, you know, oh, man, should I get up or should I call in sick? No, it's going to be a great day today. I won't call in sick. Ah, damn these stealth games. There's so many of them. But I really want to know what happens in the story, so, you know, I put up with it. I know I could just YouTube the story, but it's really not the same. It's not the same experience. I mean, you really do have to play it yourself. because each little gameplay element is a story unto itself. For instance, once upon a time, there was an agent named Pear-Shaped Snake. And his job was to rescue a hostage inside of a compound. He met a very nice young man. Come on. What the hell are you doing? Oh. Yeah, get back up. Get back up. No, no, get back down. Oh yeah, I don't even know what happened there. I just made these hesitation moves, you know. All right, last stand, gentlemen. This is your test of courage. Pardon me while I reload. Oh, the sun's not going to help in this situation at all. And they come from behind? Where am I? I have no idea what you're talking about. Oh, are you still alive? Oh, you're such a troublemaker. Oh. You're pinned down? What are you talking about? What is this thing here? Just gonna give you a little hint of where I am. Oh god, come on. Ugh. Oh, the game's not perfect, you know. Do-do-do-do. Oh, somehow this is actually working out better than when I was planning all this out. Thank you. What else can we blow up? Sorry, you just gotta make do. Oh, that wasn't very nice at all. You guys okay? Yeah, can I get out of the box, please? Out of the box. Out of the box. Thank you. Hey, just came to check up on you guys. Everybody doing all right? Oh, you guys are sleeping on the job? I am gonna report this to your superiors at once. Let's give him a little fun here, huh?
You destroyed their anti-air radar? It wasn't one of the targets, but that's put a hole in their air surveillance. The chopper will be able to get in close now. You can designate a landing zone near the outpost.
Oh, good. Oh, no, wait, where are you going? Sneakiest agent in the world. Oh, you're new. Whoops. Start running. Oh man, somebody boy. I mean, he already hit snooze. He's not gonna get up. Oh, it's not even in range. Good thing you came to his rescue. Why am I actually doing better? Just going with the full frontal assault. Yeah, cease fire. Yeah, quit firing at me. Man, that's just mean. I'm not sure what I'm expecting to do there. Yeah. Ugh. Do-do-do-do-do-do. That's right, just dig in. Dig in. You're fine. What? You still made it? See you later.
You gotta extract him.
Well, I'd say that's a pretty successful sneaking operation. Now, what do you think? Alright, well, let's go pilfer some stuff. Can't pilfer before I rescue this guy. He'll just send me off and complete the mission. Hey, where was that guy that was sleeping? Did I wake him up? Oh, I'm sorry, dude.
The material. It could be just what we need to develop new weapons and equipment.
I personally hate it when somebody interrupts my nap. Take your tape. Yep. You making my dreams come true. Can't listen to that anymore. Well, this place is lightly stocked. I'm a little disappointed. How are these soldiers supposed to survive? Oh. Just a minute. I'll be right with you. Well, he's already been a hostage this long. He's not going to wait another couple more minutes. It's fine. Whoop. I didn't hear you.
That looks like the target.
It better be the target. He's the only one left breathing. I hear about that, about you. Well, I'll be seeing you later.
Target extraction confirmed. Your objective's complete. Exfiltrate out of the hot zone by chopper or on land.
What are all these containers? Can I mark these containers? Oh, yeah, I would need more than one balloon, wouldn't I? Well, just for good measure. Oh, I used all my C4. That's right. Oh well. Anything in the guard shed? Maybe some Snickers bars or something? Oh, you do have something. Ah, thank you. All right. Now, what's left here?
Please select a landing zone. The support helicopter requested.
Ah, it's way up there. I just got down from coming. Just got down from climbing there. Ah. All right, fine. I'll go back up there. Oh, well, not before I pilfer some things. I'm like Robin Hood, except just the Robin part. Let's leave this stuff just lying around. Phew. Anything else here? Oh.
This is Pequot. Arriving shortly at LZ.
So am I. So am I.
This is Pequot. Have arrived at LZ.
Support helicopter has arrived.
Oh, don't land on top of my head. Oh, that'd be a disaster, huh? Hey, come pick me up. Ah, I'm dead!
Gaining altitude.
Buddy, departing area of operations.
Departing.
Extraction arrived at mother base. Development project has been added.
Mission complete. Phew, at least you made it out in one piece.
I thought I did, you know, fine.
The engineer we rescued has been extremely cooperative. The guys on the R&D team are glad to have him aboard. Thing is, his specialty isn't mechanics, but something called bionics, engineering based on biology. He's already submitted a proposal for modifying your prosthetic arm. If you're interested, go ahead and give the development order.
Ah, D. Oh, well.
Psyops list updated.
This war. The Kremlin never expected to have this much trouble against the Mujahideen. Afghanistan is a tribal society. Tradition demands that its people stand up to any outsiders who set foot on their land. With the honor of their people at stake, they have everything to fight for. No matter how hard the Soviets hit them, they continue to appear out of nowhere, striking back, then vanishing again. But there's one thing even the Mujahideen fear. Every last one of them, the Soviet gunships. They're highly maneuverable and equipped with massive firepower. Plus, the underside of the fuselage is heavily armored. The Mujahideen can barely scratch them with their small arms. Anyone who hangs around gets mowed down by the gunship's heavy machine guns. This new honeybee weapon that was given to the Hamid fighters, it's no doubt something to help them strike back against the gunships, which may that could change the course of the war. Those guerrilla Mujahideen don't actually belong to a single organization. Afghanistan is a multi-ethnic country. You've got the Pashtuns, the Tajiks, Uzbeks, Hazaras, and each of them is split into their own tribes, large and small. Each ethnicity has several rebel organizations that their various tribes gather under. They're united under the banner of jihad. That doesn't mean they work like a single standing army. Just look at the area around Smossy Fort. A lot of Tajiks used to live there. They fled after the Soviets started their scorched earth campaign. With the area uninhabited, the Hamid fighters, who are Pashtun, decided to move in. The Hamids are based out of the city of Peshawar. We passed through it on the western edge of Pakistan. The Pashtun people have long lived in Afghanistan and western Pakistan. They used to travel back and forth frequently. Then Britain went and established the border that still stands today. The Hamid fighters get generous support from the Pakistani government. The The government wants to use them to secure influence over Afghanistan. Their liaison with the Hamids is Inner Services Intelligence, and behind the ISI, you have the CIA. That's probably how the honeybee ended up in the hands of the Hamid men. Those guerrilla fighters known as Mujahideen don't actually belong to a single organization. Afghanistan is a multi-ethnic country. You've got the Pashtuns, the Tajiks, Uzbeks, Hazaras, and each of them is split into their own tribes, large and small. Each ethnicity has several rebel organizations that their various tribes gather under. They're united under the banner of jihad. That doesn't mean they work like a single standing army. Just look at the area around Smossy Fort.
Whoops.
A lot of Tajiks used to... Ocelot said the number of private forces is increasing, and they model themselves after us. They're a far cry from the likes of us. But why? 9 years ago, we made enemies of the world as a nuclear-equipped force, independent of ideology or state. Yes. Sooner or later, the real UN would have stepped in. So why are they giving these PFs free rein? That's our fault, too. What do you mean? What happened 9 years ago was a real problem for a lot of people. An organization as big as ours, with our facilities, was wiped off the map. Not an easy thing to hide. But if our existence came to light, so would the names of our clients. We had contracts all over, east and west, from superpowers to banana republics, the lot. Our clients denied all association with the likes of us. They had to make sure things didn't blow up on them. But at the same time, they missed us. They really missed us. The demand for armies for hire was as strong as ever. The international community turned a blind eye to what happened to us, despite still needing people who could do our jobs. History couldn't afford to lose us. As soon as we were gone, they needed a replacement. So private forces spread everywhere. And they're all just a phone call away.
But still.
I know. PFs are totally different from what we envisioned. Nation states, revolutionaries, terrorists. They have a lot of clients. And Cypher is one of them. Cypher stays anonymous. But I know their work when I see it. In the eyes of those clients, the world's PFs are all just expendable pawns. The clients don't have to worry about losing their own men. Nobody knows they're involved, and PFs are cheap. In short, the world is chewing up soldiers and spitting them out. Even some of the old Mother Base's survivors are still working for PFs. Some guys created their own smaller forces. Others were taken on by emerging PFs. Everybody's gone their separate ways. But none of them are living their dream, because they're not fighting with you. Of course, I tried to headhunt as many of them as I could for Diamond Dogs. It was all a waste of time. They said they weren't interested without you to lead them. But now you're back. And everything's gonna change. We'll unite all private forces under you, transcending nations and economies. What is a nation? Just a patch of dirt. The bonds among us will surpass nations. And that's what'll put the world under our control. We'll establish a new kind of country. Redefine the very concept of it. Even Cypher will be below us. An extraterritorial federation of military nations. The United States of Force. Once word of Big Boss's return starts traveling, that'll be our true deterrent against Cypher. In other words, no one will dare to come gunning for you.
How do you figure?
Cypher lacks a large-scale fighting force. PFs are the perfect tool for them. But those PFs revere you. The legendary Big Boss. If Cypher killed you now, they wouldn't take it lying down. Maybe they'd even go looking for revenge, but they definitely wouldn't keep doing Cypher's dirty work, even if it put their lives at stake. That's why it's no longer a benefit to Cypher to get rid of you. The very fact that you're alive is our greatest defense against Cypher.
Nice to know. It'll buy us some time while we get back to full strength.
Just keep in mind that what I'm saying is generalizing a lot. In practice, the PFs around the world don't know your face. Just declaring that you're Big Boss won't be enough to convince them. And if they see you as an enemy, they'll come at you with everything they've got.
Some hero.
That's why you need to bring them back to Mother Base. Show them on your terms that you really are the one and only Big Boss. Once you've proven that, they won't hesitate to join us. We were lucky to get our hands on that cyborg arm developer. There's
no one in Diamond Dogs who can so much as maintain that thing.
Bionic arm, not cyborg, if you go by what he calls it. But you're right, the East is light years ahead in bionics. They can even detect through the skin the slight electrical signals from the brain that order muscles to move. The Soviet Union completed their first bionic arm capable of doing that back in the 60s. Although I guess that news didn't really reach the West.
No kidding. Zadornov's was the only one I ever saw. Quite a shock to see it for the first time.
And it was no mean feat to get hold of Snake's arm. I couldn't get one for you at the time, but you know, now...
Forget it. I've no intention of relying on bionics. Right now I need to keep the pain fresh in my mind.
Well, it's your decision. But don't you find it... inconvenient?
Not a bit. But the phantom pain... it never lets up. Do you know how many men I saw die that day? There's nothing we can do to bring them back. And you expect me to care about getting a measly arm and leg back? Sorry. But my pain belongs to all our dead comrades. I'll keep living with it for their sake. It'll guide me straight and true until I've gotten them the vengeance they deserve. Snake, do you remember Amanda?
Yeah, I do.
Their revolution was a success. Somoza resigned, and Nicaragua has a new government. Amanda's really working hard for her country to be reborn.
Good for them.
She says she wishes Chico could be there.
That revolution was the dream. For Amanda, for Chico, and their father.
That chopper was no place for Chico to die. I'd like to at least think history will remember his part in the revolution.
When you pick up a gun, there's always a chance you'll die for nothing. He knew that as well as the rest. Now that he's gone, it's up to the rest of us to decide what it was all worth. If we don't, there's nothing to prove that Chico ever lived at all. We're his mark on the world.
Amanda told us that Strangelove contacted her after the revolutionaries came to power in Nicaragua. Strangelove, the AI researcher from Mother Base?
I remember her.
We'd lost touch with her, till Amanda heard from her out of the blue. She told Amanda she wanted to salvage Peace Walker's dry parts, or something from the bottom of Lake Nicaragua. Amanda passed the request on to her friends in the new administration. She's a national hero now, after all. So Strangelove got a Soviet military aircraft to transport something to somewhere. But apparently the cargo wasn't big enough to have been Peace Walker itself.
So what was it?
Who knows? We recovered Peace Walker's nuclear warhead ourselves 9 years ago. What could Strangelove have been after? Amanda said she didn't mention what her reason was or where she was headed. Nicaragua is a socialist state now. And with Amanda vouching for her, the government didn't feel the need to concern itself with the details. All Strangelove told Amanda was that she was going to continue her research, and that the rest was a secret. Right before the attack, Huey was in the control tower to prepare for the inspectors. He was with them when it all went down. The control tower collapsed with the rest of its strut. His body was never recovered. But he was the one who met the inspection party when they arrived. And he was the one who showed the nuclear inspectors to the tower. You remember the way it went. First he recommends we agree to the inspection. Then he gives them the okay without our permission. All the time acting as if he was doing us a favor. On top of that, he even had the guards disarmed that day. It would send the wrong message, he said. Whatever the angle. It all leads back to Huey. I curse my own stupidity for not realizing sooner. Huey escaped with that unit by chopper. I've been hunting him for 9 long years. The other reason I was operating around Afghanistan was to dig up his location.
Huey's in Afghanistan?
Yes. And I have a good idea where. Now we just wait for the right moment. This time, we'll be the ones using him. He's going to tell us who our guests really were that used a fake nuclear inspection to blast our home into the ocean.
Alright. Let's see here. Construct more platforms. One or more units has reached maximum staff capacity. By building more of the relevant unit platforms, your base will be able to house more staff. Okay, I like to have more staff. Okay, so what am I full on? R&D, huh? Sure, show enough.
Platform construction.
Let's see, am I getting full on anything else? Base development. Oh, not unlocked yet. How about the support platform? Yeah, sure.
Commencing platform construction.
Oh yeah, I'm making jobs. Oh yeah.
Select unit.
Okay, don't care about that.
Please specify a project.
No, I'm fine with that. Let's get that arm, huh? I'll say cargo extraction. Fulton device. Yeah, yeah. I need more of that. Let's do it to be on the car. And the mobility. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, I'd like to get cargo. Those useless boxes just lying around there. I could have taken all that stuff. Hand grenade. Yep. I might use those once in a while. Ah, the boxes are super annoying. Yeah, forget the boxes. Oh. Might as well. No, I don't need it for the sortie. Why do I want the speaker though? I don't want that. Everything else is locked. Side left here. Target practice, support unit platform. Destroy all within the time limit. Stand at the starting point and press the action button to make the targets appear in front of the training. Weapons, non-lethal weapons only. Well, not sure why I would want to do that. Secure blueprints and help advance R&D at Mother Base. The right SMG. It's tempting.
Please select a mission.
Where do the bees sleep? I recovered the U.S. military's new weapon, codename Honeybee, hidden at Smassai Fort. The Soviets are also after it. Well, I can't let them have it, can I? Yes, equipped everything now. Oh, I look exactly the same.
Deploying.
Let's see, blueprints are required for the and items. Blueprints can be found in places such as outpost buildings and guard posts, and can also be obtained as rewards for completing dispatch missions.
Masilama.
I hope it's not the same bees that are from Metal Gear Solid 3. I always thought that was ridiculous. Even though I know it was a real project. You know, fighting a boss that was shooting bees at you. Yeah. That wasn't Metal Gear's one of Metal Gear's greatest moments. Let's see, we're gonna go all the way over there. So I am going in the wrong direction. Okay. Ooh, hey, look at that. Huh? What? Who? Where? Huh? Oh, okay. I didn't know you guys were gonna be there. Hold on a minute, I'll be right back. So let's first determine if you're worth killing. I mean, capturing. You guys are gonna chase after me on foot? Did you say I was on a horse? Oh, really?
Analysis complete. Analysis complete.
Oh, you're both aren't too bad, actually. Well, well, well. Looks like you're gonna be working for a new team here soon. Ah, give me a break. Are you guys still running? How far do you think I went? Oh, you guys are way off. Where the hell are you going? Over here. Who are you yelling at? You're right next to each other. There we go. Nighty night. Away you go.
He's coming too. Roger that.
Oh, well, that was quite a trek, huh? Well, they better be worth it. Ah, like hell I'm walking the whole way. Okay, I'll meet you halfway. Thanks, buddy. Alright, well. I didn't know the guard post was going to be that... that close. Those guys were overachievers, though. They were way, way, way far out. I'm going to give them a promotion when they land in my platform. After they, you know, wash my underwear. You wondering where those other guys went? They're not coming back.
Analysis complete.
Ah, that guy was like a B-level mechanic. Yeah, he's gonna be taken, that's for sure.
Analysis complete.
C-level box. I don't know what that is. Any other assholes out there? No? No? Ah, that guy in the tower is troublesome. Let's see, you good at anything? Ah, that's right, you're a C at the box thing, whatever that is. Well, I really only want that guy. I guess you guys are shit out of luck, huh? I have to be a little more picky now that I have less room in my place. You won't believe what I have to tell you. Yeah, everybody, there's only one other person with you.
Marker placed.
Standing still with a shooter. Yep, here I am. Oh, I'm sorry, were you going to call for reinforcements? Down the mountain we go. Oh, he's sleeping on the job and everybody else is working so hard. Do. Oh, I guess I should clean this place up, huh? This place is mine now. There you go. Stay cozy by the fire. Maybe you'll catch on fire, too. Hey, I didn't say this place was mine. What the heck? Is there another person around here? Okay, I know you got the cool candy bars up here. No, you got nothing? Ah, alright. Okay, my fine leathered friend. So useless. Yeah, haha, they can't get me now. Whatever. Yeah.
Extraction arrived at mother base.
Oh yeah, materials. I'm a material girl. Whoa, whoa. What? Oh, hey, hi. Funny I should run into you on the way to capture some other people. Actually, I've been playing a while. Why don't we start with right there? This is Autopostrophe, and you have been watching Metal Gear Solid V, The Phantom Pain. The sneakiest, most covert operative out there, Pear-Shaped Snake. I hope you've enjoyed watching. I will see you at the next stream here very soon. Thanks.